Now let's move to next one, SAN, that is a storage area network. So in organization, or we can say in company, we have storage devices. So let's talk about them. Let's talk about SAN, storage area network. So let's understand things in this way. These are few computers you have in your network. And you have connected them together by using any switches. So they are connected together. Now there are a few information on this computer that has been shared. This is nothing but this is a file or folder. File or folder that you have shared over the network. That means any user which is using this computer, he can access the this file because this file is or folder is shared. Okay, so let's say if this computer is on, so he can access this, the user can access all the resources which is shared on this computer. But what if this computer is turned off? Can he access? He cannot access. So on that cases, the company is use some storage devices. Okay, something like as a NAS. This is network attached storage. Nothing but this is known as a network attached storage. And this device would be attached to the network. And this is kind of storage devices. Storage device. So the data which you are putting on this storage, and you can share that data to other computer as well. So till this storage is on, all the device can access the data. So this kind of network, when you are attaching your storage over the network, okay, any storage over the network and sharing them, so this kind of network would create a SAN, storage area network. Okay, so in a storage area network, all the storage would be attached through the network, and user would be accessing those storage via network, not through the computing services. Okay, so this kind of network would be known as a SAN, storage area network. So I hope all types of network, this is a physical network, and it would be clear for you. Okay, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's fine, great. So let's move to next one. Now we have talked about network, okay, or types of network, but how you would arrange your network physically or logically? So that is known as a topology. So now let's discuss a network topology. Okay, so let's talk about network topology. So network topology is nothing but this is how you are arranging your devices, or how you are connecting your devices over the network. That would be known as a topology. So now let's talk about topology. Let me just write here. Way of connecting computers or network devices to each other is called topology. So how you are connecting your network devices, okay, so that would be known as a topology. So there could be two types of topology. One is physically and other is logical. So let's talk about them. Physical and other thing is a logical. So these could be two types of topology, physical and logical. Okay, when we talk about physical topology, you can see here, this physical topology you can see. Okay, so how computer are arranged over the network, you can see. So arrangement of computer or network devices, you can see. Okay, so by seeing the connection you can identify. So and in logical, you have to understand the logical theory. You cannot see that would run within the devices. So physical can see the physical topology, but here logical topology you can't see. And this logical topology would run within network devices. So we'll discuss about this. Let's talk about physical topology first. So we have different types of physical topology. Okay, and let's talk about them. A physical topology could be 4 or 5 types. Okay, so let's discuss about them. The important topology I'm just telling you, bus topology, number 2 ring topology, number 3 star topology, and number 4 mesh topology. So these are 4 physical topology which is very famous. Okay, so how you are arranging your computer over the network, that would be defining your topology. So if you are arranging your computer as a bus, so it would be defining as a bus. If you are arranging your computer as a ring, so this would be defining as a ring. So let me just show you all topology, how it works. So I would just talk about bus topology and take the example here. However, nowadays it is not used. I mean, physically it is not used, but logically, yes, it is used. Okay, so let's talk about physical topology. Bus topology physically. So let's say you have a computer, 1, 2, 3, and 4 computer you have. And those you wanted to connect to each other. So you would take one wire. Okay, this wire is nothing but this is a coaxial cable. This is coaxial cable. So you might have seen a dish TV cable. That kind of cable is known as a coaxial cable. So you take this wire and you use some connector. For example, you are using T-type of connector. And you are connecting these computer to each other. Okay, here you are using terminator on both hand. So this is coaxial cable. This is a terminator. And this is T-type connector. Connector, and on the computer side you must be using LAN card. So LAN card would be BNC LAN card. Okay, so this, as you can see here, how computer are arranged, they arrange in the bus format. Okay, in a single line they are arranged, and that's why this topology is known as a bus topology. But this is not used nowadays. The reason is, I mean, physically you don't use this. Okay, the reason is this is very slow, and this is not secure. Okay, so for example, this is A computer and this is C computer, B and D computer. You have four computer and they want to communicate to each other. So if A is sending any data to D, so it need to make sure that the media would be free. Okay, this media would be free while this is sending any data. Other computer do not send data, otherwise the collision would happen. Okay, so let's say this is sending any data, place some data on the wire and trying to send, and meanwhile if B also initiated data to sending C, so at that time there would be collision and data would not reach to destination D. And this is the reason this is very slow and this is expensive. So this was used in a old time, but nowadays it is not used. Same way you have another topology, which is ring topology. So let's talk about ring topology. So here computer would be connected over the ring. So that means you can, let's understand, when you are connecting computer in this way, this types connection, if you are making the arrangement, so that would be known as a ring. So benefit of a ring topology, you would see that there would be two connection. Okay, at least if one of the cable would get frayed, so the computer would use another connection, this path, and they would be communicating to each other. But the problem is, again, this is very slow and this is insecure. For example, let's say this is A computer, this is D, this is B, and this is C. Now A just want to send data to D. Okay, so it can send via this path. Okay, this is the nearest path. But if A just want to send data to C, so on that cases, how it would be sending the data? Either it would be using this path or this path. On both cases, A data would go via B and B can see the data, or A data would go via D or D can see the data. Okay, so this is not secure. And again, this is a slow, and this is against, there is a chances of data collision. For example, A is sending the data to C and meanwhile D is sending data to B. Okay, so there is chances of the collision. So again, this is a slow and this is expensive, and that's why it is not used. So what is the next topology? That is a star topology. Let's talk about a star topology. So a star topology is used nowadays. And if you talk about a star topology, so there would be computer, okay, like this. And there would be some central devices. Let's say this is switch. This is nothing but this is central network devices. And all these devices would be connected to this central network devices. All these computer would be connected to this central network devices. And you can see the formation of the network is something like that. This is a star topology. So this is nothing but this is a central network device. Device, it could be a switch or hub. It could be switch or hub. This is central network devices, and physically they, you would see that the devices are arranged as a star, and that's why this is known as a star topology. So advantages of a star topology is you know, now this is a faster. But the disadvantage is, you know, because this is a central network device, so this is single point of failure. If this device goes down, entire network would be disconnected. All the computer would be disconnected. So this is star topology. This is faster, but nowadays we are using this as well. Okay, so this is your star topology. Now the next topology is mesh topology. Mesh topology. What happened in this mesh topology? Let's say you have four computer. So each computer would be connecting to each other. For example, this is computer number A, B, C, and D. These are the computer. So they would be directly connecting to each other. In this way, it seems like a ring, but they would be directly connecting to each other as well in this way. So this is kind of mesh topology. All the computer would be connected to each other. The problem with the mesh topology is the number of computer, if you are increasing, you have to increase the network interface card as well. For example, let's say you are adding one more computer over the network and you just want to connect them under mesh. So you have to increase number of interface card as well. So this is the mesh topology. This is most reliable, but this is very expensive. And this is very difficult to manage a mesh topology. But you can see that each computer would be directly connected to each other in mesh topology. Okay, so any question from these topology? These are the physical topology.
No, sir.
All right, let's go to next one. So we have talked about physical topology. Topology, this is done, where you would be able to see physically. Okay, now let's talk about logical topology. Logical topology. So logical topology is like you have a bus topology. This is again logical, and you have token ring. This is again logical. So we will discuss about them later, what are all these things. Okay, when we will learn about switches and hub devices, so we'll discuss about that. Now let's talk about setting up a network. When you just want to set up a network, what are the things required? So let's talk about setting up network. Setting up a network. So if you just want to set up a network, what all the things required? So three things required. If you just want to set up a network, one is an IC. This is nothing but this is a network interface card. Network interface. Card. So that is one thing you have required. The other thing you require a media. And the third thing you require are network devices. So if you just want to set up your network, so this is your requirement, network devices. So these all things is required when you just want to set up a network. NIC, this is a network interface card. So let's talk about NIC first. What is this and why it is important? So I would be showing you picture over here. Just a moment. What is network interface card? And I hope you are already knowing this. So let's discuss about this network interface card. So this is nothing but this is a LAN card. This is network adapter. This is also known as a network adapter. And this would be present on the computer so that you can connect one computer to another computer. Okay. So let me show you some images. So on your computer system, it would be looks like this. Network interface card would be connected to your computer. It could be wired or it could be wireless, okay? But this interface card is enabling you to create a connection between one computer to another computer. So let's talk about them. What is NIC or network interface card? So I would talk about NIC, that's a network interface card. We also say this is, we also know this network interface with various name. For example, we also say LAN card, or we also say network card. Okay. So what is the use of this? This is the interface between two computer. It's nothing but this is interface this is interface between your computer between computer and a network. So if you just want to connect to your computer through network, so this is the interface. This would work as an interface. We say network card, LAN card, or we say Ethernet card to this. Ethernet card. So this is the various name of this. Okay, if we talk about this LAN card, so this contains MAC address. It contains MAC address. MAC is known as the media access control. Control. So it contains MAC address. Like in your phone, you have a IMEI number, right? So same way in computer, you have a MAC address, and this MAC address is a unique. Okay. So now we will talk about it contains MAC address. MAC address, sometimes we say MAC address or we say physical address. MAC address is also known as a physical address. So I would talk about MAC address. What is this? This is a physical address. Address and physical address, it's a similar to IMEI number of mobile. Similar as IMEI number of mobile. In mobile, you have IMEI number, and you know that is unique identifier. Your IMEI number and my phone IMEI number could not be same. Similarly, if your computer got any MAC address, okay, that is unique, and your computer MAC address would not be matching to any of the world's computer MAC address. So this is a physical address, and this is this is written where this is stored in your network interface card. Okay, this MAC address. So MAC address would be burned within an IC, network interface card chip, and that cannot be changed. And cannot be changed physically. Physically, you cannot change it. So this is very important. Okay. So for example, if there is any hacking is happening from any computer, okay, so their MAC address would remain unique and that cannot be changed. This MAC address is 48-bit MAC address. If we talk about bit, so what is the size of MAC address? This is 48-bit. And this is divided into two parts, 24-bit and 24-bit. Okay, 24-bit is known as a manufacturer. The company who is manufacturing this MAC card, I mean interface card, so it would be identified with the 24-bit. So we will talk about them. So how it would looks like the MAC address, okay? When you run the command get MAC on your computer, let me just open it. So cmd. Okay, so this is my command prompt, and if I run the command get MAC, so I would be able to know my MAC address, and this is known as a physical address. These are the MAC address. So in this computer I have different interface card, many interface card, and for that's why I am just able to see this MAC address. So this is MAC address, and it is written in a hexadecimal format. So you can see that one hexadecimal format, this is 8-bit. So overall, you have a 6 part over here, and 6 into 8, how much? That's a 48-bit. Okay. So if you put this MAC address on internet and you want to know that this is from which company, so you can see that this would be, maybe this is Realtek or something, any other company network interface card. So this is the network interface card, which is containing, you know, MAC address, and MAC address is really important, okay, to uniquely identify any computer over the network. So we talk about network interface card. It could be a different types. Okay, network interface card could be a different types and could be supporting a different speed. Okay, so now I would talk about network interface card supporting speed. So with what speed they can share the data over the network, that's known as a speed. Okay, so you have a Ethernet type of interface card, which is serving maximum 10 Mbps, megabits per second. That's a Ethernet. Then you have fast Ethernet, which is serving the speed 100 Mbps. And finally, you have gigabit Ethernet. Gigabit Ethernet. This is supporting 1 Gbps. This is the speed of your network interface card. 1 Gbps equal to 1000 Mbps. So this is supporting. So these could be Ethernet types. Okay. So nowadays you would see that the network interface card is coming. They are supporting gigabit Ethernet speed. So hopefully this an IC has been clear. This is network interface card. That's a one component that is required to build a network. The other component is a media. So if we talk about media, media could be two types. One is guided and another is unguided. Guided media, where you need to guide it, that how the traffic is going to flow, and that another is unguided. So example of guided is your wired media. Any wire, this is wired media, this is guided, and unguided, this is a wireless, where you don't need to guide that how it should go through. So that's a unguided. Okay, now I would be talking about guided. There are different types of media in guided. Number one, coaxial cable. Coaxial cable. So you can see the DISH TV example. DISH TV cable is a coaxial cable. The other is a twisted pair cable. And finally, you have fiber optics cable. Fiber optics, or we can say that optical fiber. These are the guided media. In twisted pair itself, you have two types of cable. One is UTP, unshielded twisted pair, and other is a STP, shielded twisted pair cable. Okay, so I'm just going to show you all the picture of them on here. First of all, I would showing you coaxial cable. You can see this is the coaxial cable, and you might have seen your DISH TV cable is a coaxial cable. So in this coaxial cable, you can see outer jacket. Then you can see that this is nothing but this is a shield, and then you have this copper wire. So this is actual wire which is containing the we carry the signal. Okay, and it required a connector. This is a BNC connector. And you can see here, this is connected through connector. So this is the coaxial cable. Now I would say twisted pair cable. So this is twisted pair cable, and you would see in this twisted pair cable. Okay, I would show you that what all the use of this twisted pair cable. Okay, so this is twisted pair cable. So there could be two types of twisted pair cable. One is shield, where you would see there is a additional layer. Okay, and another is unshield. So this is example of unshield. Okay, so you have shield and unshield twisted pair cable. Okay, and finally there is a fiber optics cable. This is very fast. This fiber optical cable is a very fast, and you would see the fiber optical cable in this way. Now you are getting internet connection at your home, okay, and they are providing you fiber optical cable, and this is connected through this type of connector. So this fiber optical cable, you won't see any metal wire on this fiber optical, but you would see a small fiber tube which is carrying the signal based on the light form. Okay, so this is the fiber optical cable. So these are three media. Okay, which is comes under the guided. You have unguided media as well. So let's talk about unguided. That's a wireless. So unguided example, you can see those are the wireless. So let's talk about them. So now I'm talking about unguided media. Unguided media could be two types. These are example of wireless. Okay. And it could be two types. One is infrared, and another is RF. This is nothing but this is a radio frequency. So you can take example of TV remote. TV remote is basically working on infrared. So you would have a maybe guided media, which is working on an infrared. And you can take example of RF, that is a Bluetooth. Or your Wi-Fi, wireless fidelity. These are example of your wireless media. Or RF, this is radio frequency. Okay, now the third part is network devices. So you have a different types of network devices. We'll talk about them. So far we have understood that to create a network, we required a three thing. One is network interface card, an IC. The other is cable. And the third is we required network devices. Network devices we have, for example, we have switch. We have hub. We have router. So these are nothing but these are network devices. And we have many more network devices. For example, switch, hub, router, bridge, etc. These are the network devices. We'll discuss about them later. Okay. But these are the network devices, including we may have firewall as well. That is network security devices. So I would type here, etc. We have many network devices and we will talk about them in detail. Now, let me just create one diagram over here that would be representing entire network. I can use this PPT only, that would be representing entire network. So this is the PPT and here you can see this is the entire network. And I would let you know that how to identify that which is what. Okay, so let me just talk about all those segments. So this router, this is the router. And this is what? This is comes under the network devices. This is cable. This is what? This is media. And then we have some servers over here. For example, this is server. Okay. This is nothing but the server. And here, if you see this segment, the server is connecting to this central network device, which is switch, via what? Via network interface card. Okay, via an IC. So these are the component within the network segment. Okay, so hopefully you would be able to understand that different segment of the network, you would be able to understand through this. Any questions so far? Okay, if no questions, so let me just... Okay, so these are the thing. I just want to keep today just basic only. The next thing is a cabling. So we will understand what is cabling. Cabling is very important. Important things. So if you want to connect your computer through network, so it is important to which cable you need to select and how you can use or what is the cable coding. We need to understand this. So we have different types of cabling. This is the mechanism to connect your computer via cable through the network. And we have different types of cabling mechanism. So we will talk about them. If we talk about UTP or twisted or STP. So we are using most of the time this kind of cabling. So how we create a cable so that my computer can connect to over the network. So we have some cabling mechanism. So we have cabling, for example, straight cable. Or we have another type of cable that is crossover cable. And the third, we have rollover cable. So these are the cabling mechanisms we have. So I would discuss about a straight cable for a moment. What is a straight cable? So let's say you are connecting your computer and your network device, for example, switch via cable. So here you can use a straight cable. If you are connecting same device, for example, computer to computer, if you are connecting, so here you can use cross cable. Between same device, you have to use cross cable. And the rollover cable, for example, if you want to connect your computer via console cable, so there is a console cable which is used to configure devices. So let's say this is switch and you are connecting via console port. So for that, you can use rollover cable. So these are the cabling mechanism. In next lecture, I would tell you that how you can create our cabling. What is the mechanism to create the cabling? So I would use a crimping tool and I would show you live how we can use the crimping tool and connect the cable. Any questions so far? All right. So if there is no further question, so for today, I'm just keeping basic things.
Can you please explain this rollover cable again?
Rollover cable is a console cable. So usually we have switches. Let's say this is switch. And I just want to configure this switch. So how I would access this? So in computer, there is a console port. So there would be console cable, which would be connecting to this console port of the switch. So the cable which we use here, so that would be console cable. Console cable, and the coding of this cable would be rollover cable.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, welcome. So I'm just keeping basic today. I'm not just going on advanced topic. And before, next lecture, I would recommend to search some cabling mechanism on YouTube. On next week, we will let you know how you can create the cable, straight cable or crossover cable or rollover cable. So I'm just giving back you next 30 minutes. You can use that. And for today, I'm just stopping here. All right, guys. See you next week then.